drones. We hear more and more about them in uses that run from the dangerous to the fanciful. In the last of his reports from a recent trip to Peru, Jeffrey Brown looks at a new unlikely use of drone technology. It's part of his ongoing series, Culture at Risk.
Archaeology, the study of human history, the past. But that doesn't mean it can't use the latest technology to achieve stunning images like these. It's happening here in Peru, where Deputy Culture Minister Luis Jaime Castillo is overseeing pioneering work using drones to protect ancient heritage.
These are only tools, means to an end. The end is preserve our cultural patrimony and whatever we can deploy to achieve that.
Yeah, but they're tools that require a certain, technological know-how, a certain geekiness, right, to get into them.
But, I mean, if you're going to be an archaeologist and you're in a little bit geek, I mean, you're in the wrong field.
Machu Picchu is Peru's best-known wonder, but the country is home to thousands of sites, large and small, 100,000 by one count, a rich terrain of history and culture long before and well after the arrival of the Spanish. Their protection is a major project and problem, especially as cities expand and populations explode. That's what's happening here at Pachacamac, a huge complex that for more than 1,000 years served as a religious center, home to an oracle consulted by leaders of several pre-Columbian Indian groups, including the Incas. Sitting above the Pacific Ocean, Pachacamac is some 20 miles outside Lima, or at least it used to be.
This is ground zero for the defense of archaeological patrimony.
When Luis Jaime Castillo was a boy, he says, this was considered way outside the city, but no more.
Now we have a wave of 10 million people that needs to grow, that needs services, that need housing. And what used to be 30 years ago a shanty town that was pushing and pushing the site, now is settling into a very modern, very vibrant, economically very important sector of Lima, but of course in need of more space.
That means bumping right up next to, and in some cases onto, ancient temples and palaces. Archaeological work at Pachacamac still requires old-fashioned tools, spades, brushes, and dustpans, here to carefully dig up human remains. But on the day of our visit, the ministry was also using something slightly more sophisticated, a new drone called the S-1000, an octocopter outfitted with a high-definition swivel camera. After takeoff, an operator manned the drone while another monitored the camera, capturing video and photos of a palace owned by the last ruler of Pachacamac before the Spanish came, and of the nearby town just over the wall.
We're finding out the funny thing that, I mean, the best pilots are not engineers or archaeologists, our drivers. I mean, if you can drive in Lima, you can fly a drone.
Boys with toys. There's certainly an element of that here, but there's also a very serious side to all this. Back in a nondescript office at the Culture Ministry in downtown Lima, the hundreds of photographs shot by the drone are uploaded into advanced imaging software. And just hours after being shot, look like this. A 3D model and map that show precise boundaries like a blueprint, incredibly accurate. And these can be and are used in court as legal documents to evict developers and squatters who build on protected lands.
But if you're going to map something that has property around it, you better be precise to the tenth of the inch. Because otherwise your neighbor is going to come and say, this is my property.
My property. As we showed in a previous report, the Peruvian government dispatched a drone recently to document damage to its famous Nazca lines, allegedly caused by activists from Greenpeace during a climate change protest. Still another use of drones is for conservation. At Chanchan, once the largest adobe city in the world, the drone's mission was to document the state of restoration and decay ahead of El Niño storms that have brought havoc in the past and are anticipated to hit again this winter.
We have to have the before and the after, No, if there's any damage, we need to go back, and that we need to have a record of what was there. No?
The hope now, funds permitting, is to build up this newfangled air force throughout the country, placing at least one large drone in each of Peru's 24 regions to watch over its archaeological heritage from above.
It's part toy, part high-tech research. The very old meets the quite new. I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour here in the Chan Chan Archaeological Site in northern Peru.